Hello, everybody. How y'all doing? Lovely to see you here, responsible day traders. Today is a Monday, January 27th, 2020. I am Lindsay Duff, and this is Responsible Day Trading. Man, I got some work done on my lower back last week on Thursday. I almost feel like a new woman today. It's amazing. We're gonna feel better, okay? And by we, I mean me. And if y'all want to join me in feeling better, I'm down with it. You can probably already tell from just the way I'm talking that, man, I feel so much better than I have the last few weeks. Chronic pain is a nightmare. I mean, when you're in pain for two straight weeks and you're wondering how this is gonna get better, and then one day you're just like, oh my god, it's a whole new world. Enough of that. I do have a sick child who has the flu. I'm waiting on a text to come in from the pharmacy to say that her flu medicine is ready. I'm scared to touch anything of hers. I didn't even want to hand her the thermometer this morning. I was just like, yeah, you're doing on your own. But yes, flu is confirmed. Just keep me in your good thoughts. Keep me, the other people in this household, just keep us all in your good thoughts, because otherwise, positive thinking, echinacea, zinc, just vitamin C. I'm going to do it all, and I just took my other vitamins. Lots of water. I need to remember lots of water. Eat healthy. Everything. Stay on a good track. I can do this. I can beat this flu virus, okay? It's got no power over me. All right. I see the market's moving, so let's go check it out. One last thing. We do have FOMC this week. It's on Wednesday, 1 o'clock. Central time, so 2 Eastern. Just be aware of what that has a tendency to do. It has a tendency to hold up the party a little bit. Let's go ahead and take this off of here so we can utilize that space. If you haven't noticed, I put more space on my 1597. That is absolutely intentional. There is a giant gap. I've refreshed my data about 15 times. Don't think it's a data issue. I think we just had a giant gap. Let's pull up the daily chart. Oh my god, you were so much easier to find today. Wow. Okay. I don't know if you listened to what I said a couple of weeks ago or a couple of days ago, the last few trading days, but what we tend to see happen with a stall out like this, not a lot of movement, is a pretty decent pullback. And man, if this BB keeps up the pace it's got right now, this is going to be a decent pullback. Maybe we come right back into the next EMA. Who knows? I don't expect to see that in one bar, but maybe in the next few. Now, here's the thing. We had a snap back. We've got a lot of space to run back to it. We have not had a reversal bar that tells us to go back up. It's going to be hard to get back below all these areas. But if this keeps up the pace and the BBs traveling down like that, we'll see it give us a really good retracement. Okay, so let's check out the 10946 next. Open this puppy up just a little bit. It's not pumping open. We don't want to go too far because we need to see what's going on here, right? And if we spread this out, the bars start to get a little weird, trying to really encompass the whole space that we, it shows us really all the space from the highest pivot to the lowest pivot, right? And if we spread that out, it makes things look a lot bigger than they really are. So we had a nice push off the area, pulled back, had a hold up right here at this area again where it went down further. Nice divergence right here, pulling it back into strong EMAs. We pulled back into these EMAs several times, had almost no reaction to the downside. So we may see this come back a little bit further. If we come back into this 3266 area, we've been at this area before, it's held before, we may see it holding. We do have some strength in the MACDs to the downside. Let's check out the 4181. So the 4181 is already crossing over these areas, right? So it's crossed to the upside. Let's kind of pull this back a little bit to take that out of the picture. And when I say take that out of the picture, I mean like this big drop, because it gives kind of a skewed look to things. So if we come back here, the MACDs are pushing up right now. They do have strength. We are pulling away from the Bollinger Bands. We just want to be prepared for maybe something like this. A lot of times after the roll-in and it pulls away, it'll snap back inside, right? And right now it has no... It doesn't look like it's trying to, okay? So what are we looking for? That's the question, right? I'd be looking for this to pull back and push up a little bit more. Don't know that I can give this full attention. Her medicine should be ready in about 30 minutes, so I may just do this analysis and come back to it a little bit later. I've got some time this afternoon, so long as my little sicko down there does all right. I really do believe in these shorts. I keep trying to convince myself to take the longs. Giving this a shot. It's gonna have to break through here. Shot to the downside. One tick. Obviously, the bigger ones are still pushing down here. Now we've reached an area. I think I may take this one. A little reversal bar, slowed down, pulling really far away, reach this last area, so we may get a pretty decent snap back from here. I don't know, we may just keep going, but I'm okay with that. You know how I am. Let it go if it goes. The zero line here, but really expecting to push further. Let's see if we're gonna make it any further than that. I'm recording. Okay. Ooh, look at here. That out. It may pull right back up here. Oh, there we go. Okay. This guy should be calling me back any moment. My phone is a buzzing. Yeah, I'd have been stopped out for sure. Let's go ahead and wrap this up. What do I anticipate? This to push back down all the way down to here. But it is already way later than I wanted to trade today. I have a call in 30 minutes. And my phone is buzzing at me, and I got someone about to call me out of my freezer. So, let's go ahead and mark these up. 7.5 points with 3 trades. Okay. So I did come back down here a little bit lower. The phone, just, it never ends. I told my daughter earlier, I was like, it never ends! All right, gave us a double bar, pulling back, higher pivot here. Yeah, I think I exited. Let me look at this on here. We still had a lot of strength down here. Could have held on a little bit longer, but I'm okay with things, you know? I'm down with it. Okay, so I have a call in 14 minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and shut that down for today. There's a chance I may not trade tomorrow. But I guess, you know, we'll see if I can make some time for it. I definitely will. My kiddo is home with the flu tomorrow for sure, because she is not allowed back in school until Wednesday. All right, guys, I hope everybody has a fabulous Monday. And as always, you know, I look forward to catching you on the profitable side. Bum 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 b